turn it real quick.
Ah, this is my coat. Okay.
Yeah.
See, I didn't even know we had stuff like that.
See, that's about what I like the soil level.
Okay. Yeah, about an inch.
Yeah. Let's see now, how many of this, select some good specimens over here. Okay. And I figure we can probably put 4 or 5 to a pot. And you'll hear terminology when we cut the roots off.
Mm-hmm.
That's called root pruning.
Root pruning.
Yes, you actually prune the roots back, and believe it or not, that invigorates them.
That makes sense.
So I'm going to prune this one a little bit.
Okay.
I'm going to take about that much off.
All right.
And about that much off. Now that one's ready to pop.
All right.
And on this one, it's got a little excess stem on it here, so I'm going to take that amount of stem off.
Okay.
And that little bunch of roots, and so that one's ready. And let's see. These little guys here, he's got a little much on him. Take about that much off of that one. And the rest of these should be okay.
Huh?
Let's take a little bit of that off. Now. Okay. First we're gonna get the big one.
Okay.
And I'm gonna put him sort of center.
Alright.
And then we'll make a little family planting around him. So since he's pretty big, I'm going to kind of do it this way. These two tiny little fellows.
Both are tiny.
But they will grow.
to get all three of those in.
All right, three of them in.
Do we need to, you can prune a little bit of that off, about a half inch of it. A little bit more, right about there. Perfect. Okay. Lila's got a plant that's been in her office for about 12, 15 years. It's a split leaf philodendron.
Oh, yeah.
And this thing is like this tall. And it's got a stalk on it that's probably an inch, inch and a quarter in diameter. And she was asking me what I could do with it. I said, well, what we're going to do is we're going to try to air layer it so we can take all the top growth and start a new plant. And hopefully we can encourage the bottom to sprout again. So keep the main root, but I'm going to take the top plant, I'm going to cut halfway through it,
okay.
Put the rooting hormone on it, and then I'm going to put that sphagnum moss tourniquet on it. See, why don't you put that little fella right about there, next to those little ones.
If I was thinking I would have taken a picture, I have a U4BACA in my office.
Mm-hmm.
That came with us from Atlanta back in 1994.
Wow, I bet it's huge.
It's, man, I don't know if it's huge. It's certainly, well, it was this little itty bit. In fact, there's still where she put the little thing to help it grow. It was about halfway up, and it's still there. And then the rest of it was just.
Yeah. I love you for this.
Well,
did I see one? I thought I saw one in here someplace. No, I saw a calancho. I saw a calancho over there. I don't see a euphorbia here.
Well, she got me that. We got it at a monastery outside of Atlanta where they, you know, they sold good baked bread and plants. And they said that plant has
served you well, huh?
Well, it has survived all this time. I brought it and a crab in a fish tank. And the crab maybe lasted a few days. Well, the office that I used to be in had really good sunlight, so when she had a plant that wasn't doing so well and maybe could use some more sun, we would just take it to my office.
Let it rest out and hang out of your place.
Yeah, nobody seems to die, so. And of course, that doesn't hurt to, you know, go into somebody's office where they've got nice plants.
Okay, a saucer. One of those.
Is that one?
Does she have a pot this color? No. I don't guess
she does.
Well, we'll keep her.
That one's kind of small, isn't it?
Almost too small. Yeah. The one on the bottom will work. It's a little bit larger diameter. Yeah.
Okay.
Perfect.
Oh, okay.
All right. Got the coleus family. Thank you. right, get your pot and rock.
Okay, so same size pot.
Mm-hmm.
And your rock. Oh, first rock. Take the...
Take that off, yeah. Because one thing you don't want the toxic swamp syndrome. Too much water sitting in the bottom of the pot in the soil.
Right.
It's drowning them and then killing them from the methane that's produced. Get your dipper here and get your pot over here.
Okay.
You're gonna fill that about half. Oops.
Back where you are.
Yeah, get that in. Go ahead and just put a good load in on top of it and then compress that down over the rock.
Okay.
And that rock won't move around on you anymore. There you go. Now that didn't feel good to the hands. Get you about 12 granules of fertilizer. Just about. Maybe that's a little much.
Yeah.
Close enough. There you go.
Coming around.
Mm-hmm. All right, a little bit more soil on top of that, about an inch more. And kind of spread it around and compress it. Pot up to within an inch.
Okay.
Being full. Maybe a little bit more.
A little more. Okay.
There you go. A little bit of moisture. You can use some of that. That's the good stuff for sure. That's plenty.
Okay.
Give it a moment to kind of soak in. See, let's get the, I usually take my leggier ones and put those in the center.
Okay.
And then the smaller guys will put them around the edge.
Makes sense. Okay. So.
Let's see, on that one, let's take about two inches off of that. Yeah. All of that. Yeah.
All
there
right.
You go. We might add a little bit more soil to that, Jim.
Okay.
I'll let you go ahead and get it in. I'm going to get some soil here. And we'll bring that soil level up a little bit.
All right.
Yeah. You can take a little, put it under running water, and it should stretch them out pretty good. can tangle them, or you can take the end of the scissors and kind of prune them out there, preen them. There you go. Tease them.
Okay.
Yeah, there you go.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Okay. And how do you...
Cut about that... Yeah, there you go. Perfect. Well, we started packing up things at the house. Fixing to tear it up. We're going to move out, you know, and
right.
So that these remodelers can have run of the place.
Oh. And where are you going to go while they're doing that?
Oh, we're in the process now of trying to get some temporary domicile, trying to find an apartment that is furnished.
Okay.
And short-term lease, something 2 to 3 months. He said he thinks they can probably have it done in 30 to 45 days, but, you know,
but,
barring any unseen and unknowns. So.
Yeah. But enough work where, I kind of wonder about that. Sometimes people stay, other times you kind of have to... You wouldn't have any peace of mind.
I wouldn't. And I don't want to be waking up in the morning, got to rush out of bed and get out of the way of contractors and all of that. I don't want that. So.
Yeah.
It's not very appealing to me.
No.
You know, I acted as my own general contractor and built a significant portion of that house, and that was when I was young and really interested in that sort of thing. But I'm no longer young, and I'm certainly not interested in building houses. So.
You think if you stayed around, it'd be too hard for you not to watch what they're doing or make comments, or not necessarily?
Oh, I will. I'll watch what they're doing. That doesn't bother me. I just don't want to live in it.
Okay.
You know, you're going to have copious, and I'm having them scrape all the popcorn off of the ceilings. They're going to rip the floors completely, tear all the carpet out, and all the...
That popcorn
the wood.
Stuff.
Yeah, I hate it.
Whose idea was it that was going
to
be nice?
I don't know, but I would like
nobody
to...
Nobody...
Let's give him a drink of water,
Jim. That's right.
Yes.
Yeah, everybody I know, I don't hear anybody these days saying, I'm going to put that up out here. I'm going to scrape that off.
Yeah, it's got to go. You know, and it's nothing like having a nice, wonderful morning cup of coffee. And you look down in the cup and there's one of those little popcorn balls floating in it. Or you're having conversation with someone at the dinner table, and they start doing this. You know, something's falling out of the sky. And see, we're having when I designed the house, I designed it with a sunroom.
Okay.
The house was large enough that it would accommodate us, and so we said, well, why spend the money now? And we're not going to need that room, so we didn't build it, but now we're getting it added on.
Okay.
So.
All right. Let's see.
So we've got two good pots of that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We could plant two more, but these probably could go in an individual pot. They're gonna, because if you cut about that much off, these are gonna grow really hard and fast. Where's Miss Tracy at today?
Oh, somewhere.
What about this pot? Does she have a special dream for this pot?
I don't think so.
We could put those two as a group in one pot.
Okay.
This one here's a nice deep pot, so.
Yeah, I think she. This is part of the, okay.
Oh, that one's already got a wheat hole in it and a tray on it, so.
So all we have, do we need to put a rock in there?
No.
Or no? Okay.
Because, see, when the water, when you see water standing on the outside,
uh-huh.
You just tilt it over and get the excess water off of it.
Okay. All right. So, okay, so first.
Need a little soil.
Soil.
Kind of compress that. You can put a little water in it. Get your 12 grains of fertilizer or so.
You're like Rain Man here sitting.
You know, now he was the mathematical genius.
Yeah.
Mystery of the savant. I knew a young man who was savant. But his deal is music. Never had a piano lesson in his life before, but he
that's just amazing.
Yes, it is. He hears it one time and he's got it. It's just amazing.
The way that we've been designed, the kind of potential that people have.
A little bit more in that one. Yeah, these have got some, we're going to leave some heavy root on these, so we're going to put them, make sure we got plenty of that on them.
Ah, okay.
Pull that big one out, and let's see if we can decide where you're going to do your cut on that. Uh-huh. How much stem do we have versus root? Look like we've got, what, inch of stem? Most of that's root, though. Wow. Oh, my. We can probably take about that much of it out, Jim. Okay.
Now we put this one and that one, so mm-hmm. we want one kind of each.
Yeah. One to either side, and they'll grow together, I'm pretty sure. They take off. Soil in over the top of that.
I think so, yeah.
I got a little bit here, probably a tablespoonful to one side.
Okay.
Right in there. Then you kind of pull it back up above the soil level as you're compacting it down. Okay. Yeah.
Okay. I see what you mean. Okay.
Let it get him to stand up generally straight.
Yep.
Take it right across there. Yeah.
Okay.
There you go. Kind of go around this that's around the edges of the pot.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, make sure you kind of compact that around the edges and push them in towards the center there.
Okay.
There you go. Hey, that's good.
All right. And a little more.
A little more of the good H2O. And we're good to go.
Wow.
Now you got some excess water in there, do you? Is there? You can actually add a little bit more water to it. Just little dribbles here and there around the pot will be good. Make sure there's plenty in there. Status. Surely she's gonna see this and say, oh, what a name, what a name. He's playing with the pots.
Let's see what else.
Yeah. have African violets.
Is that the stuff that I had her get, or?
I see perlite.
Or did we decide we didn't need that?
That might have been what we decided we didn't need, but it's all it is it's basically this soil.
Uh-huh.
It's just ground up finer.
Okay.
But I think this will do just fine.
Okay.
I really do.
Okay.
And we won't add any fertilizer to it because I'm not sure what type of plant that is.
All right.
We're just going to put it in the bare soil with perlite in it, and we should be good. But let's, did you bring them over?
Oh, yeah.
See what the roots look like on these. They're kind of delicate, viney looking things, aren't they? Ah, ooh, very long. So we're definitely gonna take about that much off of that one. Yeah, let's see what we have here. Does she have a name for this? Did she?
No.
Boy, that's unusual wort growth. Sends out two main. This one's the same way. You see, it's two main. Roots should grow out. Okay. Get back out of the water until called upon. Sort of a deep pot for them because I can see they produce a lot of root.
Okay.
Maybe. Oh, here's this little problem. This
one. Oh. Is this what she?
No, that's the azalea.
Never mind. Okay.
That's food.
Okay.
A rock.
All right.
And okay. I'm gonna get the bag. You can get directly out of here.
Said we're not going to put the fertilizer in
No,
here.
We're not putting fertilizer on it.
All right.
I'm not sure. They seem to produce a lot of nitrogen. See how dark green that plant is?
Yes.
It produces a lot of nitrogen, and I'm not sure that it will need any additional.
Gotcha.
Further down in the soil.
So
How much root do we have left on that one? Let me see.
This one?
I might want to take a little bit. Let me see. Well, I think I'm going to have to take a little bit more off of this one.
Okay.
Take it off to about there on that one. And there on that one. Okay. You're going to have fun getting those springy roots in there. What I would do, Jim, is maybe what we need to do, another little, when you have a plant, these roots are, they're axial to the main stem.
Okay.
Let's look at it real good here. You see these grow out horizontally from the main stem.
Right.
What we want to do is get this guy seated about here. But we want to make a little trough out through here.
Oh, okay.
Get him seated.
So we're not shut. Okay.
There. And we're going to try to get his plants off to the side.
So we're not shoving all that down in one little spot.
Right.
That makes sense.
Because he's got a peculiar habit. And tells me he wants to grow more to the surface of things, more so than to the depth of the pot. Get in there. All right, there we go. Now we'll do the other one to this side, and then they can meet in the middle someplace. And what I might do is just take a little handful of fertilizer and put back over the top to make sure we've got good coverage. Just get them sort of pressed down there. We'll put a little extra soil over the top of them.
Okay.
Just get some in my hand and we'll kind of sprinkle it over there. Those curly Q roots. Okay, hold that down right there. Yeah, this is going to settle nicely.
You're not leaning too much to the side or anything?
No.
No?
No. Phototropism.
What does that mean?
Plants will track where the light is strongest.
Okay.
So eventually, what we want to do is possibly get these out on a table in the backyard to where they're getting that strong morning light.
Okay.
And then they'll be in subdued light for most of the afternoon, and they will grow straight up, basically.
Okay.
They will grow towards the strongest light. Thank you.
philodendron?
That's a philodendron. Okay. A very young split-leaf philodendron. And we can definitely put him in the standard soil. Because he's basically an air plant.
What does that mean?
They take most of what they need from the air rather than from the soil.
Okay.
The roots in this plant, you know, they take up about 80% of this plant's moisture is taken in from the air. That's why they love to be misted. They're okay. Tropical. The roots are only there to sort of anchor the plant.
Okay.
And to keep it in its optimal growing environment. But most of the nutrient that they take up is not so much taken up through the roots. Boy, this is a nice specimen. She did a great job in getting him rooted. So what we're going to do, take about that much of that out, and when we plant this one, we're only going to put the one in the pot by itself,
uh-huh.
And we're going to kind of spread these roots out
okay.
So that they grow out around the pot, and we need to start this one in a sizable pot.
Okay.
What about that little black pot right there?
This one here?
Yeah. That should be enough depth, but it's certainly diameter is important with these. Because these roots here, they're not going to grow so deep in the soil. They're going to grow right underneath the soil surface. Okay. I'm going to take a little bit more of them off. This one, I will. Take some of that. And on this one, I'll take some of that.
This one doesn't have a.
Just,
we have to.
It's got a reservoir though.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, that's the reservoir in there.
Right.
And we can add a little plant food to this one. So about another scoop of that, a few granules of plant food, and then we're going to finish it out.
Okay. Just a few.
Mm-hmm. Compress it and add a little liquid to it.
Oh.
Go ahead and add some liquid. I'm gonna get some more soil here coming.
So how much fishing are you getting to do lately?
I haven't done any lately.
Last time you were here, you were, I think your wife called to remind you, you were taking somebody fishing the next day.
Yeah,
right?
My grandson, my Little Rock grandson, Ellis.
Okay.
He loves it.
Now, where do you take? Where do you usually fish? Beaver Fork or?
No, I fish on Conway.
Okay.
I fish up on Lake Brewer. That's the Conway Water Reservoir.
Okay.
And I fish the Arkansas River.
Okay.
Several the Toad Suck Pool, as
okay.
well as the North Little Rock Pool. Now the way we're going to get this one, Jim, we're just going to have to take our time,
right,
and get these main terminals spread out, get them headed in the general right direction. These lower ones here, I get a few of those in down there. Get a few of those in down there. A
now, if you will, get a little soil in the scoop, okay, and we're going to top cover this one. Just very, very little. Because he's susceptible to what's known as root crown rot.
What's root crown rot?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
This plant, that little plant that was growing the horizontals out.
Yeah.
That's why I didn't want to get it planted too deep, because where those roots emerge from the main stem, that becomes the crown of the plant. And some plants are really susceptible to, if you keep too much moisture on that crown, it'll rot.
Okay.
And now you can root them in water and they're fine, but as soon as it gets in dirt, it doesn't want to be, that crown doesn't want to be wet anymore.
Ah, okay.
Subdued light for this guy, and we're in good shape.
Okay. But she had him over here in the corner. Should he be closer to the window?
Well, you can give him a little bit of window for a few days, but it won't take long before, you know, he'll be off and growing really, really well. Water should be running through.
Is it not?
He may be root bound.
Is that when you have to re-put him in a
larger pot?
Yeah, I should probably check the U4 to work. I bet that thing's pot bound.
If it's been there for a couple of 3 years, I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah, it's because it's definitely changed size of its pots over the years.
Yeah.
So, So when the water isn't coming through, is that a good, is that a possibility? Because it's so pot bound that the roots are all...
Yeah, they fill the pot up more than likely. I think this is weeping through a little bit. Just being into weep through. And then again, too, I don't know who potted it. They might have really compacted the soil in the bottom of the pot and let it cause the water to run through a little bit slower. Get something out of the edge here. Make sure it gets down there. Yeah, it's weeping now. It's just pretty dry.
Okay.
It needed a good wet down. Was this on a tray?
Yeah, let me go find it. I think it was.
Sometimes when they're like this and you got a nice deep tray, you can pour your water in into the tray.
Okay.
And it will absorb it up through the pot. So.
Yeah, it's extension guy.
It's draining.
Okay.
Yeah.
I never knew that. The extension guy was explaining that to me about how putting the water down in there as opposed to in the soil.
Well, you know, there are certain plants, they don't want any water from the top side. African violets are one of them. You get water, too much water on the leaves, and they put black spot on the plant, and you just about have to water them from the lower extremity of the plant. Just sit the plant over in a saucer or a bowl of water and let it absorb into the pot, because they certainly don't like getting their heads wet. Right.
same as that, we can put this in another pot, and then we'll make a little home for that off to the side.
Okay.
Now this is going to take a large pot.
Okay.
Pot on the order of this pot.
All right.
Let's get down here. I'm gonna use. Now, this week you will observe something interesting. This plant will tell you pair of gardening scissors?
Yes.
That's what I think. Or so. an old knife. What I need to do is score these sides
Okay. And
sort of break these roots up a little bit. It's got some main roots in it here.
I wonder if this is useful.
Yes, this will be just perfect. Because I need to get in here and find these main roots.
Okay. And I've struggled with this before too. She's good at this, but I'm not. When we brought things home and you had to take them out of the pot from the store and...
Yeah, if you don't,
it's all packed in like that.
Because if you don't untangle them, it'll girdle itself, and it'll start to die, and you'll never know why.
Okay.
And it was just about to get girdled.
Oh.
See, it's got some significant sized roots in there.
Okay.
We got to get those out to where they can feed.
Come on, dog. Yes, you're very happy. You're going into the bedroom. And you're quiet.
So the trick is to just kind of pull them away without obviously tearing anybody up.
Right. To where they can get down. And see, that's the main root right there. And it's grown down and back up again.
Ah, so, okay.
I think we'll do it. Dress this one in from the top of the pot with soil. I need to get that soil back out. And I don't know if Tracy will be home during the day, but this guy here can probably put him out in a place in the yard, outdoors, where he can get a little bit stronger sunlight. Since this one wanted to break off, We're going to take it and stick it in the jar and see if we can get it to reproduce.
That's
one that just broke off. Okay.
nice strong sunlight here on the inside, but he should be one of the first ones you move outdoors.
Okay.
If you got a table or out on your bench where you can get some good strong light.
Yeah. Or maybe one of those where you take them out and then bring them in during the day or at night?
Well, just make sure that, you know, like if he gets 2 or 3, 4 hours of sunlight a day,
uh-huh.
then make sure you just put them in the shade. And then in a week, I would say, just generally speaking, in a week to 2 weeks' time, all of these, if you just set up a makeshift bench out there, you can start leaving them out during the day, overnight. Just like probably right here in the shade of this tree, you'll get that morning sun.
Right.
And then they'll have, you know, nice subdued but strong sunlight in the evening. Have these started to bloom yet?
What, the tomatoes?
Yeah.
Don't know.
Well, I was going to say, probably what we could do is go ahead and feed those.
One thing I gotta wait for every year, I gotta wait for the cabins.
Yeah.
And all that oak trees come off. The cabs, miserable.
Yeah, we're gonna get the cabs, I'm sure.
Yeah, so it's best to keep that out of the pool if you can help it.
This is the Calidus here.
So?
Yeah. That is. This goes with this.
Let me show you a couple in the garage here.
hyacinths need to be placed in the ground. Soil. We can plant these in potting mix, but garden soil is a little bit heavier. Kind of get, if you get me a broom, I'll get my mess cleaned up over here.
Okay.
It's almost dinner time.
Okay. Well, how much longer do I have yet? Or is this it?
This is it for today. But there's always next week and beyond for sure. I tell you, when you get a chance to speak with Miss Tracy, let her know that the hyacinths, for sure.
Yes.
They need to be out there where they can get a minimum of six hours.
Right.
And they need to be planted 5 or 6 inches deep in the ground. And for just those little plants, you have to dig a hole about this big.
Okay.
Amend the soil down in there. Put lots of good fertilizer, organic material, a good layer of that in there. And then we'll plant the bulbs on top.
Okay.
And we want to put about 5-6 inches of soil over the top of those. And when they're heavy ground feeders, in other words.
Okay. And when they emerge next spring, they'll look just like they do in that pot.
Nice and full and prolific.
Two types here.
There's Arrowhead and Pothos.
Okay. So, any quick advice on?
Same tactics.
Same as sweeping.
Yeah. These are all tender water starts, and you've got the science down basically.
Yep.
Now, on these, I wouldn't add any fertilizer to the soil for either of these.
No fertilizer for any of this. Okay.
Because they're viney plants, and they're basically in the, what is particularly the pothos, it's an air plant, about like the philodendron. As a matter of fact, pothos and philodendron are in the same family. And the arrowhead is a removed cousin.
Okay.
They all come from the tropics, basically, and they have pretty much the same meager requirements.
So basically, I know what I'm doing with these and these, okay?
That's yes.
Because that's going to take me a while to...
Well, actually now...
I made a big dent, but there's still a whole bunch there.
Well, she's got a lot of starts here.
Right.
She's been a prolific starter. but these can be really consolidated.
Uh-huh.
You want several of these. This one doesn't belong in that group. This one belongs over here.
Okay.
But you can take several of these and get them in a pot because that's what they want to do. There.
Oh.
Dustpan?
Oh.
Successful. Alrighty.
Alright, there's real quick. I think she said she had some Hoyas out here.
Some what?
Hoyas?
That looks like a Hoya there.
Yeah, that's what she said they were. Okay.
Yeah, that's two Hoyas.
Okay.
And you want to plant them pretty much the same way.
Same thing.
Okay. Definitely want to give them a little root pruning. Okay. I take about down to there.
Right.
These two can be planted together.
Okay.
And they will form one good plant.
It looks like a lot of these are like that.
Yeah, these are philodendrons. And you want to kind of size them up. Your stronger growers, you want to put them together. And the ones that are near the same in size, like...
So you don't want to mix and match.
Because you don't want your strong growers to be in the pot and they, you know, overshadow the little guys. Like all these little guys like this, you can group them together.
Okay.
I saw one that doesn't belong, though. Where is it? It's this one. This is an arrow here.
All right.
It needs to be over here with his grouping.
See, I would have mixed and matched. I would have thought of that.
Like this little family right here, mm-hmm. all of these are just about the same growth, same stem size. Actually, this one here could go with them. All of these could be consolidated.
Okay. Now, what kind are these?
These are philodendrons. Yeah, povos.
They're
pothos. Okay. But some of them are solid green and some of them are variegated.
Do we have anything that looks like hydrangea cuttings? Is that there or something else I have?
Those are hydrangeas right there.
And which ones are those?
These.
Oh, these?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So.
And I'm not seeing a lot of roots, but that one's got a little root on it.
Okay. Quick advice on that.
Actually, the hydrangeas.
Did you say wait on them or?
No, they should be in pots.
Okay.
This one will have a good chance of surviving, and you want to plant it right up to those terminal buds there.
Right.
And I take about that much of the stem off, and make sure these two buds stay outside of the soil. That one is a nice healthy specimen.
Okay.
This one hasn't developed a lot of roots. You want to take about that much of the stem off and plant it about that deep.
Okay.
And then right here at this bud, take this head off and just plant the stem.
Take
this old dead. See, it's sucked all the life out of this head.
Oh, okay.
This one, I don't see any root development on it, so leave it in the water. I don't think it's going to make it, but